was the cock show. What can I say? Hey guys, welcome to Overwatch Apex Season 2. I am Doan. Finally, back with us once again is Monte Cristo. And welcome to the Oasis. You know, I'd expect there to be a few more plants than this, but it looks okay. I'm not going to judge. Well, I should also say welcome to the Oasis, the place where you could be hit by cars really easily. Not a lot of safety around the roadways.
Well, I mean, most people don't just walk into highways.
But look in the bottom left. There's a green light that says walk, man.
Oh.
Look at that. It's just leading people right into traffic. That's really unsafe. And it looks like Afrika Blue scrambling a bit to hold on to this one. Arhan just sitting on top of the pillar for the moment. He's got to deal with him. Mano goes down. The hands of fate were not kind.
Mano, the hands of fate. Manos. I wonder how many of our viewers will actually get that.
I know. It's a Manos reference. I got to do it. Some people out there will get it. Hopefully somebody does. If there's even one, I'll be happy.
Anchor has been ulted, but didn't swing away at all, just opting to keep his shield up and push them back slowly. So not the best use of nano boost.
It's about sending a message, man. It's the intimidation factor, right?
Look at my electric armored man.
That was originally going to be Tony Stark's Iron Man motto, but he decided against it. Look at my electric Iron Man. Iron Man. Did you say Iron Man?
Armored Man.
Armored Man. Oh, okay. Look at my electric armored man. There we go. Got it.
He missed out. It's so catchy, though. It's so catchy.
You know, I used to just walk around the streets of New York shouting that and never got a response.
Well, that's why you were in the asylum
pretty
for
normal
a while,
for
actually.
New York. Yeah. Arkham Asylum. Looks like teams here in Korea wasting no time in doing that. Oopsie.
Whoops. Might be a pretty big mistake.
When I was a girl, I was afraid of small buildings.
Is that what you were afraid of?
That's right. You know, as a young girl in Paris, you can see our audio issue.
You can
see that we have an audio issue.
Hear you saying that there's an audio issue.
That's right.
But there's not an audio issue
not with
on
us.
The stream.
No, we're fine.
We're good.
Our audio is perfect.
It's like
flawless.
Honey for your ears.
That's right. It's like liquid gold for your. Wait, no, that's you don't want liquid gold poured in your ears.
No, you don't.
That's that guy from Game of Thrones. Didn't seem to work out too well.
That happened in real life, too.
Yeah, to a lot of people. Recently? Were you a part of this? Or are you talking about, like...
No, like in the medieval era.
Oh, okay. Just checking.
Yeah. No, I don't actually...
I just wanted to make sure.
I wish I had enough money to waste gold like that, Doa, but...
I mean, if, like, TSM players start disappearing, I'm going to start getting worried that that's maybe what happened, you know?
I'm glad you think, Doa, that I'm going to assassinate pro gamers. That's really touches my heart.
It's not...
That's
you know,
why I'm actually in this industry, right?
It's not so much that you would do that. It's that I expect you would do it with molten gold.
It's a stylish way to do things, for
you know,
sure.
If you're going to... You know, why not go all out? Breaking Bad taught us that you should not go with half measures, right?
That's right. And I take all of my moral advice from Breaking Bad. Did you know that?
I just use it for kind of an example for my pizza throwing skills, you know?
Right on the roof?
Right on the roof.
Right on the roof right. Every time. He really nails it, by the way. It's right on the roof.
It's all about what
time.
You take from the show, you know? I take the more wholesome things, I guess. Yeah. Throwing pizzas. Why not? I was really into Ninja Turtles back in the day, too. It's chained throughout my life, this pizza chucking thing, you know?
We'll have to make some YouTube videos about that soon.
I would love to.
Doa versus Korean pizza. You know, most Korean pizza...
Oh, don't get me started, man.
Most Korean pizza actually deserves to be thrown on roofs rather than eaten.
Deserves to be thrown into an incinerator, I think. The sun, maybe, which is the universe's best incinerator.
I agree. Pizza school does deserve to be thrown into the sun.
That's true. Man, like, they put corn in the sauce and pizzas here. You have to specifically ask them to not do it. I love South Korea. I've lived here for, like, almost 6 years now. I love it here. But please stop putting corn in your pizza sauce. It's an abomination,
it
man.
It is. It's terrible. I like corn, but corn on pizza is truly awful.
That's right. I mean, some things are good together. Peanut butter and jelly, you know? I mean, I don't know, like other things that are good together. But corn and pizza sauce.
Don and Monty, we're great together.
We are great together. We're definitely no corn and pizza sauce, that's for sure. Name a greater duo. I'll wait. I heard that's a popular meme with the kids on the Instagram.
You know what's Twitters. You know what's hilarious? Is the first time I saw that picture, I had no idea who those people were.
I don't know. I still don't know who those people are. Who are those people?
I think they're like sort of related to the Kardashians or something. But
everyone these days?
I guess. And I also just can't imagine a bigger waste of time than following who the Kardashians are as people.
You know, I thought that the Kardashians were very entertaining where they were that species in Deep Space Nine. They're really funny to watch in Star Trek.
Kim Kardashian.
Yeah, that's right. The Kardashians. That's who we're talking about, right?
Yeah, but they were a totalitarian government, you know.
They were funny then.
They were basically space Nazis.
Yeah, but it was pretty funny. Same time.
Space Nazis are
always
hilarious.
Asking people how many lights are there and all that. You know, those Kardashians. They love making people count lights, I guess.
They do. It's their favorite pastime.
That's right. I bet they're. They throw pizza on roofs, too, I've heard.
We have three lights, though. I know you would say four, but we actually have three.
There are four lights! Yeah, that's right. Don't ask me. There are four. Absolutely. You knew you could get that out of me. Well done. Yeah. Well, the audio issue is ongoing. Again, not with us, with the players in the booth down there somewhere.
That's right. And you know that the audio issue is with them, not with us, because you get to hear us talk about garbage for like 5 minutes.
That's right. Garbage like pizza in Korea with corn in it. Well, garbage.
We chained that nicely into the Kardashians and then the Kardashians.
It all comes back around.
It didn't come back around at all.
It all progresses naturally.
It all progressed.
Around. Well, I brought it back to the pizza thing, right? Which is where I think kind of where we started.
It was.
I forgot already.
We started with Breaking Bad.
You know, I love the runaway team uniforms. They've got like these kind of bulky pink sweatshirts. I'm pretty sure I've seen those in like retired women in Minnesota wearing those, but they just took them right out of the closet. Put the Runaway logo on it. They're wearing them.
That's right. They're trying to appeal to the older Midwestern American demographic.
Why not? You know, that's a graphic I think that could use a lot of outreach in esports. I don't think there's a lot of big esports viewers in that area.
Hey, man, it was successful for the presidential election, so I don't know why.
Actually,
it can't be
not Minnesota, man. Not Minnesota. Maybe other places, but actually,
the Midwest as a
actually
as a
not
whole.
Minnesota.
Midwest as a whole, that went pretty well. We should try and reach out to those people as well.
Well, yeah. I mean,
I'll reach out to them, Doa.
Go ahead.
I feel for them, the disaffected white working class.
You want to make them really angry? Put some corn in their pizza sauce.
No, I don't want to do that.
Whip them into a fervor like nothing else.
Now you brought it back around.
That's right. It all came back around.
You got there eventually.
It was all part of the plan, right? Yeah, well, it seems like it's a pretty serious audio issue, guys. Wow. Uh-oh.
I know we already touched on their rather interesting pink sweater uniform. That's really quite hipster.
They are.
Actually.
Is it?
Yeah, because it's that ironic sense of dress,
well,
right?
Well, you look at Haksal, and you've got the big bulky pink sweatshirt. We're not looking at him right now. We'll hopefully get a shot of him later, but Haksal, the big bulky pink sweatshirt, and then the really tight skinny jeans. So he's
great combo. I don't really.
Yeah. Kind of like I just got done with ballet class kind of thing. I don't know. Just making guesses. It's kind of chilly outside. All right. So, yeah, headphones, are they working or not?
It's time for earbuds.
You know, I just say we just got to go the Apple way. Just remove the headphone jacks from everything. That'll solve the problems, right?
It solved all the problems, I'm pretty sure. All of them.
Yeah, that's right. Let's just remove all the jacks from everything. Everything wireless now. Charging?
Yeah, wireless
cool.
charging
that
is
cool.
Wireless charging is great.
Does new iPhone have that?
I have no idea.
I don't know. Probably not. Who knows?
I don't know if the technology
is. We aren't sponsored by Apple. We can say whatever we want.
I don't know if the technology is quite there yet, though.
I'm not sure either. But we got the earbuds covered, right? Maybe. Pause. Audio issue. Flash Lux.
It's still happening.
Yeah, sure is. And the thing is, you know, one could argue that we could be talking about the matchup more right now. But to be honest, there's really not a whole lot more to talk about. We haven't seen either of these teams play this season. Stitch backing away. Just going with the 2-2-2 composition. This time, Runaway, 2 DPS, 2 tanks, 2 DPS, and that is an Earth Shatter. Whoa! Wow, okay, a Runaway chains that Earth Shatter into a pretty huge teamfight win. And there goes Modern at the end. I guess now we can call him Postmodern.
Is that right?
That's right. It's obvious.
I like it.
Yeah.
It's like your favorite kind of art.
Oh, no, don't get me started. It's worse than corn and pizza. Stitch has that pulse bomb.
We all know you're about people have listened to us for years know about your secret love for Mark Rothko, your favorite artist.
Oh, don't get me started on that, man.
Commit suicide via reflect.
Reflecticide. That was the name of my metal band in college.
Reflecticide?
That's right. We like to think really hard about like our past, where we're going in life.
I thought you just had your stage set up with just a bunch of mirrors.
That'd be cool too, actually. But we never got around to it. We didn't have you as our stage manager, sadly.
Well, I would have been great for Reflecticide.
Well,
you me.
When we do the Reflecticide reunion tour, you're invited. Don't
Thank
worry.
You.
Hawks all looking fantastic as ever, but for me, it's all about Cox. I mean, he has so many. Oh, I couldn't make it through one match. I'm trying to be professional here, Monte Cristo.
I know, don't.
It was the Cox show. What can I say? Cox is great.
he really had
he could do so
before.
Much. All over Flash Lux. And, I mean, so much strategy.
So much
individual
strategy.
Play.
So, such a deep hero.
Why did he name himself that? This is esports, why'd you do that?
For moments like that, though. Beautiful.
I'm so sorry. I tried so hard. I got so far, but in the end, didn't even matter.
I'm gonna need that clip forever now. You're not gonna live that one down. That was wonderful.
It was inevitable. Well, run away with the easy win in their first. Shut up. Their first best of five. Welcome to esports, ladies and gentlemen.
I think that may be my new favorite Doha blooper. My old favorite was Rookie Lights Up Crack, but this one was pretty good, too.
Don't tell my wife.
Oh, man. Definitely is, so still waiting to see what Why Not's issue is with the PC.
Yep.
You can put your lips on the water bottle. Pouring it gently into his mouth. Oh, wait.
Oh,
he figured out how to use a bottle.
Whoa.
Good.
Amazing. He's taken his first step into a larger world. It'll be easier to drink a lot of different things now.
Yeah. Bottle mechanics are on point. Don't have to worry about getting it all over your face or your clothes that way.
KR bottle mechanics. Right
there. Top tier.
I think KR bottle. Yeah. Also, hopefully, Why Not gets his computer in working order. Breck. That's the sound I make when I find corn and crepe pizza.
Breck.
Breck. Yeah, if there's a pause, you know that corn and Korean pizza is going to become a topic of conversation.
It's so terrible. It's always on our mind.
It is. We were going to say at the same time.
It's so deeply offensive that it permeates my psyche on a nearly hourly basis.
It hangs like a specter over everything we do here. At night, I dream of it. I wake up in a cold sweat going, Breck!
I'm not sure what's worse, like Korean pasta or corn on Korean pizza, because for some reason, like
here, okay, I have an
it's
answer
all
for your
sweet.
Question.
Like the pasta sauces here that they make have like way too much sugar in them.
I have an answer for your question though. Corn in pizza sauce is never good. It is never, ever, ever good. While I have had pasta in Korea, that is pretty good. You know, it's not.
Where'd you go? Please tell me.
It's not the best. I've been to some very nice restaurants that. Had good pasta, and I will tell you about it. But I've never had pizza with corn in it be good. So there's the defining factor for me, is that good pasta can exist in Korea, but pizza with corn in it
so
that tastes good
here's
cannot.
Here's a question. So there even fresh corn in Korea isn't great, right? It's never good. So here's a question. If there was good fresh corn and you put it on a pizza, would it be okay? Because I don't know if that has ever been actually attempted.
I don't know. It's kind of rubbery here for some reason.
Yeah, it's really not very flavorful.
It's very bizarre. Hey, what do you know? The round has ended.
Absolutely. And who are you? Really a strong debut.
I'm Doan.
Who are you? Yeah.
We've been casting them for years, Monty. I think you know by now. I'm hurt. Hurt bad.
Well, that's not going to get confusing at all, is it?
Well, who are you is their new DPS player. There you go. This guy is a master on Genji. Actually, you and I were hanging out with Fnatic yesterday, and in their opinion, some of their players' opinions, he's actually better than Hawksaw, because we were talking about how Hawksaw looked even better in that last match, and they're like, well, who are you, man? Nobody is as accurate with projectile DPS.
Who are you?
No! Why do the Korean players do this to us? First there was Cox, and I said nothing. Well, I said Cox a lot. And then there was who are you? And now I don't know who my co-caster is anymore. He doesn't know who I am.
We're just confused.
This is going to be a tough season, man. Fight may kind of go bad with Flower. Already on top of everyone. Nice kill onto Jaehong. He hunted that Mercy down so well. Good start for LW Blue.
Absolutely merciless now.
Yeah, they are. They're merciless because of the merciless Flower.
Wow.
That's a sentence I never thought I'd say.
That is some great shooting there. On the side of Lunatic High. Double self-destruct on top of the
Let's
pavilion.
Let's just self-destruct together. Self-destructing solidarity. That was the name of my punk band's first album in high school.
The solidarity of self-destruct.
There you go. Self-destructing solidarity.
Try this a little bit sooner on point number one, but that is a huge boop that just happened.
Dude, I want to go back and see a replay of that, because that was the moment that all Lucio's dream of.
I know. We need to see a replay, because I love big boops, and I cannot lie, though.
Hey, my other casters can't deny. Yeah. Yep.
You do get sprung off the map.
That's true. Yep. No doubt. I feel a song coming up. A rap. Welcome to King's Row. Where's that robot taking that little girl? Let's pause to consider their PC issue. It looks like they're going to actually have to swap out the PC, I guess. All right, then. Well, that means we'll be chatting for a couple minutes, Monte Cristo.
That's my favorite thing to do, Doa.
Yeah?
Is it?
I know you were very excited today because I revealed to you that James Cameron has finished writing Avatars 2 through 5, and he's ready to start shooting.
I mean, he couldn't even really write Avatar 1. He basically,
he was saving all his original ideas for these next four films.
I mean, he basically, watched Dances with Wolves, and he's like, what if this was aliens?
Hey.
Except with worse villains.
Ferngully did it.
Dude, the villain of Avatar is basically just like a hilarious cartoon character.
I love the villain in Avatar. He's awesome, though.
He's not awesome.
He is so cool. He really
terrible.
Is. No, he's great because he's like such an action-packed villain, right? He's like, his ship's like exploding. I better get in a mech and jump down. He's great.
What happened to James Cameron? He used to be so cool. Remember when he did Aliens? And that was a really good movie.
Aliens was a fantastic movie.
And then he made Avatar.
But that had aliens in it, too. Different aliens. I don't know.
That movie was so terrible.
It wasn't terrible.
It was terrible.
It was not terrible.
The writing is so bad.
It was average.
The writing is so bad in that movie. Holy
moly. I can't defend it a lot, but I'm kind of curious about what he's going to do. Aren't you curious?
No.
He's curious.
I'm not at all.
Deep down, Monte Cristo is very curious about the Avatar sequels. I can tell you that.
No, you know me. Once I give up on something, I just commit to giving up on it. It would take extraordinary reviews for me to actually go see those movies.
Yeah. Okay, I'll put it this way, though. If you had to make a choice, what would you rather watch, Avatar sequel or the Beauty and the Beast remake?
I guess I'd rather watch the Avatar sequel.
I thought so. See, there is a situation where you would watch the Avatar sequel.
There is. Yep. I admit it.
But we found it. I'm glad we worked through that together.
If I was held at gunpoint and given the choices, actually, I might just die.
I think it's a pretty easy choice, watch the Avatar sequel. I mean, we've already seen Beauty and the Beast was a very good animated film back in the 90s. Did it really need to be made again with real people?
I don't think it did.
I don't think so either.
I don't really want to watch Emma Watson sing.
I don't want to watch...
I watched Emma Stone sing recently, and it didn't turn out well for me. So
you're just not a big fan of Emma's singing right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, no Emma's singing in my movie, Stella. I've decided that Emma's can't sing.
That's a very specific rule to have for your films.
Well, I mean, it's working so far.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
They keep singing in films anyway. I don't think it's working very well at all right now, actually.
I did watch Emma Stone sing, so yeah. I guess I was the big loser there.
You did.
But I've learned my lessons about Emma singing.
Hmm. You know what I learned from La La Land?
What?
Hollywood really likes Hollywood.
Oh, God, that movie
Hollywood
was
so
disappointing. Hollywood
loves Hollywood, man.
Why was that movie even a musical? Like, it stopped being a musical, like, halfway through. And even the songs that were in there, they chose actors that are bad at singing. Like, first off, Emma Stone and Ryan Gosling are great at acting, but, man, that duet was painful.
Well, you know, when Ryan Gosling got in a car, I'm like, oh, now it's going to get good. I know what happens when Ryan Gosling gets in cars. It's action-packed.
Nope.
But then he got right out and started singing again. I'm like, no, why are you doing that?
It also made me extra...
Not the kind of drive I was hoping to see.
It also made me extra offended because, you know, his character is supposed to be this great jazz aficionado, and then the music was just terrible in the movie. I'm like,
well,
you are supposed to be, you know...
Just because you really like jazz doesn't mean you're good at it.
Well, he's good at playing the piano, I mean.
Well, there you go.
His character was. Yeah. I don't know, man. That movie is horribly overrated.
It was super bad. When a movie starts out... With a song and dance number about a traffic jam.
I bet how great L.A. is.
All right, well, let's watch a highlight then, because we just can't take any more of this. Emma's singing. There we go. Here is Who Are You? About to go nuts on the Genji.
Going nuts confirmed, but man.
Yes.
Esco was really the hero of that fight, because he forced L.W. Blue just to waste their Graviton Surge.
You know,
they got so much more value out of their ults.
You know Who Are You? Was singing during that attack. It's like, City of Throwing Stars. That's what Genji said. Yeah.
I'd rather watch that, frankly.
There you go. Yep. I don't know what you would call that movie.
It would be
Overwatch Land.
Less odious than watching Los Angeles, you know, crow about itself.
Yeah.
Again.
Do electric cowboys dream of electric sheep?
Also, I'm not even going to talk about this. It's especially offensive because LA is a terrible city.
Wow. Oh, man. It's a pretty big city. All parts of it? Every single part?
Yes.
Ooh,
all
look
bad.
At this. Just ducking out of there. Man. Cowboy versus ninja. Epic battle. And it's been going the ninja's way more often than not lately, hasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, sometimes the cowboy just accidentally shoots himself in the face when fighting the ninja. Always disappointing. What is with game developers and making terrible ninjas? Like, Genji is also just a bad ninja. He's not sneaky. He's literally jumping around where everybody could see him in midair.
No. I'm going to have to disagree with you on this one. I mean, yes, he can be very flashy, but...
Why does he need to yell when he takes a sword out?
How are people going to know he's taking a sword out there? Listen to this, though. If we compare prominent game ninjas, so you've got Shen, you've got Genji. Genji's a million times better, because Shen never makes an attempt to hide. Genji can be sneaky, right? And he moves quickly, and he disorients people like a ninja should do, right? Shen literally just walks around with a giant glowing sword and yells a lot. I mean, come on.
Can we have a game developer make a ninja that doesn't yell or scream when they're ulting? I'd really appreciate that.
I'm trying to think of one now. It's hard. Surprisingly hard. Wow.
It's like, my most deadly attack is now coming.
Look out. I don't know. No. There really aren't any, are there?
No. This is awful.
Yeah. Even, like, if you go way back to, like, Shinobi or something. I mean, he was just walking along. That was a side-scroller.
Yeah, Ninja Gaiden, not such a sneaky ninja
that
either.
That, too. Yeah. Huh. Yeah,
I want a real ninja video game.
Well... You know, there have been some good sneaking games.
Yes, but not ones with ninjas.
Not ones with ninjas, it's true. Not that we know of. I don't know. Maybe there's a console game out there.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know.
You know, we don't really play a lot of console games.
I just miss Thief 2. That's what I miss.
That was a great sneaking game. One of the best, man. Absolutely.
Then they went ahead and made Thief 3 and made me sad.
Yeah. Well, Sibiolbi looks like he's got a computer that's on again, so that's a good sign.
He's moving his mouse.
Yep.
We'll assume that means that he has a PC that is functional.
We hope so. Why is the A big in DX Racer? I never got that. You know, why is that the letter they chose to make huge?
I don't know. It's not like the A looks like a seat or anything.
It's like maybe if you're like sitting in it and you suddenly go very fast, like DX Racer. I don't know. Not quite sure.
It is in the middle.
You know, there are three letters on either side of it, so it does make things nice and symmetrical.
As a former graphic designer, I do somewhat question the typography of the DX Racer logo. I'm sorry. I think they're very comfortable chairs.
Well, there goes your DX Racer sponsorship, Doa.
Well, such is life. C'est la vie. Yep. Well, I'm ready to get back in the game. Yeah, get out of the booth. Let those guys play.
Yeah,
move
everybody
it.
Out.
Move it. Monte Cristo and Doa want to watch some Overwatch.
I was really enjoying this series before PC issue.
That's right. Well, we've angered Hollywood and the entire city of Los Angeles.
I always like to defend vast swaths of people.
Pauses are really opportunities for us to create thousands of enemies.
That's right. I'm just learning from America's president, man.
That's
it was effective for him. It must also be effective for me.
Well, you're two peas in a pod. you and Mr. Trump. Well, I think it's time to get back in the game. I think it was Kings Row, if I remember right. Yeah, we're on Kings Row. There we go. All right, well, it's going to be Temple of Anubis. All right. I want those big dog robots to start, like, walking around and stuff. That'd be awesome.
Do you like dog robots better than normal robots?
Well, I mean, if they're giant, like, old Egyptian god motif dog robots, sure.
Anubis robots? He's actually a jackal, technically.
Yeah, I suppose. You are right. Can't argue with that. At the same time, that's the type of thing that only you would say. You know he's a jackal, right? Yes, Monte Cristo. Thank you. He's not a dog. He's a jackal.
I didn't. Hey, man. I just like to educate the people. What can I say?
Thank you. I feel educated as well. That's why I love casting you. I feel like I learned something, you know?
You learned. Nice. Learned about Anubis.
Educational and entertaining.
I try.
Yeah.
When I was in Egypt, though, I didn't see any dog robots, unfortunately. Or even jackal robots.
Wow. I see. I got you saying it, too. All right. Let's get into game number three. See who takes the lead. Time to go to Temple of Jackal Robots. You know, it's funny, but Temple of Jackal Robots was actually the name of my 90s, like depressing alt band.
Is that right?
Yeah. I can't believe that. Small world, you know? Well, here we are.
Did you wear Anubis costumes on stage?
We did. It was,
nice.
It was great. We were really inspired by Stargate, you know, a great mid-90s film that came out. But this, whoa, what's going on?
All right,
let's watch J-Home kill people.
Oh, yeah, whatever, just kill everybody.
I love it. Yes, keep doing that forever, J-Home.
I think he will.
I got a feeling. Woo-hoo! Tonight's going to be... No, I'm sorry. I should not. I haven't slept much lately. It's been tough. Well, Lutekai on the defense here, starting things off. Luxury Watch Blue.
Oh.
Failure. You're off the team. Oh, wait. We don't have anyone to replace you with.
Wow, it's just their communication is so impressive. Like, he was just waiting for that. You know what's going on in their comms.
Zumba.
Come on, man.
Zumba can't jump, apparently. You know, Eska, you know, known for his Mei on point two on Temple of Anubis. Who are you now? Really making a name for himself in this Genji.
I'm Monty. Who are you? Who are you now?
We're very forgetful casters today. Who are you now?
Who are you, man?
It's a season of silly names here in Apex.
Absolutely. Well, that's what
life
I love about esports. It's always the season of silly names.
Korean esports especially.
Kart is still pushing forward, and they've got a lot of time, 4.5 minutes, and who are you, man?
I'm Noah.
Damn it.
Nice to meet you.